St. Helena Hospital opened its state-of-the-art Martin O'Neill Cancer Center and Trincaro Surgery Center in 2009 as a result of robust community support marshaled by the St. Helena Hospital Foundation, whose capital campaign ultimately brought in $32.6 million. For Foundation President and CEO Elaine John, the campaign's success is a major milestone in a succession of considerable achievements on behalf of the hospital. Since stepping into the role of Chief Fund Developer, Ms. John has transformed the foundation from an ancillary hospital department bringing in $700,000 annually to a standalone organization that raised more than $15 million in 2009, including the largest gift raised in Adventist Health System West's history, an $8 million irrevocable trust. Ms. John became CEO of the foundation in 1993 while continuing to run the hospital's marketing and communications department. In 2002, after deciding she could not give her best efforts to both jobs, she dedicated herself to fund development and began working with the hospital's funding committee. Under her leadership, the committee's fundraising grew to $2 million a year, but she soon recognized there were barriers beyond her control preventing greater success. She convinced the presidents of the hospital and foundation board to agree to reorganize the foundation as a separate charitable organization and doubled the foundation's income to $4 million in 2004, its first year as a separate entity.
My development as a business leader has been attributable to my being surrounded by the highly intelligent and capable people that I've worked with on my foundation board. I've carefully studied what they do, listened to how they build consensus, observed how they've moved people to action, and I've taken something valuable from each one of them. Well, I have two answers to that question. Having a controlling boss who did not appropriately value my contribution or give me an opportunity to influence strategy prompted me to make a change in organizations. And this was very difficult to do because the university where I worked was a great institution. At St. Helena Hospital, I've been fortunate to work with three successive hospital CEOs who have given me inspiration, resources, and encouragement to excel. And truly, this makes the difference between simply showing up to work each day and having a career that I absolutely love. Be absolutely ruthless in assessing every career opportunity for its potential to help you grow. You will never get ahead if you continue to report to someone who has little, or in some cases nothing, to teach you, or who does not inspire and encourage you to achieve your very best. When people ask me what I do, I never say that I am a fundraiser. Rather, I respond that I help generous people make a difference. I consider myself to be a broker of happiness, and that's not spin. It's true. When a donor gives of his or her wealth to create something truly wonderful for someone else, it often brings more satisfaction than any transaction where you've purchased something for yourself.